All right, next and final slate for the show, it is going to be in Major League Baseball. And we got a good amount of games here tonight, so let's get into it. Beginning with the Angels at the Twins, 1:10 Eastern first pitch in Minnesota. The Twins open $1.40, total 9.5. We're seeing movement upward on the money line and upward on the total, 145 and 10 flat. Once again, Minnesota open 140 up to minus 145. Total open 9.5 up to 10 flat. 67% are leaning Minnesota, 68% shaded toward the under. Right now, the Angels are plus 130 on the money line. The Twins are plus $1.25 on the run line. We have Cahill for Los Angeles, Odorizzi for the Twins. Cahill's just 2-3 with a 6.35 ERA. Jake Odorizzi is 5-2 with a 2.32 ERA for the Twins. Now, Minnesota, believe it or not, is 26-15 overall for the year, 11 games over 500. They're also 14-8 at home. They rank 8th in scoring and 4th in hits. Meanwhile, Los Angeles on the other side, they are 22nd in road scoring, 25th in striking batters out on the road, and they've won just 9 out of 22 away from home this year. Now, total-wise, the Angels are 71% to the under in their last 7 in Minnesota. So once again, the Angels are 71% to the under in their last 7 in Minnesota. Meanwhile, the Twins are 70% to the under in their last 10. Give me the Twins minus 145 and the under 10 runs in that game. All right, next matchup, Orioles, Yankees, first of a doubleheader. That is going to be... Did I get that right? Where's my phone? I know there's a doubleheader. Did I get the pitchers mixed up? We have the O's and the Yankees. Damn it. Give me one sec. I've never done this before, but where's my phone? Hang on. Oh, it's charging. Wow. Well, we're not going to worry about that. Phone is charging. But anyway, Baltimore Yankees. First of a doubleheader. I guess it's at 3:05. This is piss poor. I have David Hess and Jay Happ probable for this game. I think that is correct, to my knowledge. I know that the lines and the line movement, I know that that's correct. But anyway, the Yankees open 260, total at 9, 10-cent fade of the Yankees. I'm barefoot. I think you saw that. Very weird. But verified, not my underwear. Anyway, Yankees open minus 260, down to minus 250, total at 9. 76% are leaning Yankees, 51% shaded toward the over. Right now, Baltimore's plus 235 on the money line. I think David Hess is starting for Baltimore. I think Jay Happ's starting for the Yankees. David Hess, 1-4 with a 5.51 ERA. Now, if you like the Yankees in the spot here, they are 24-16 overall for the year, 13-9 at home. Baltimore on the other side, just 3-10 in their last 13, taking on the Yankees. They also rank dead last in runs allowed. Total-wise, Boston is 75% to the under in their last 8. New York, 13-9 to the under at Yankee Stadium. Give me the Yankees minus 1.5 and the under 9 runs in the first of the double dip. All right, I think that's a good time to take just a quick timeout. If you're upset or mad at my timeouts and my shout-outs, just skip like 3 minutes ahead or 4 minutes ahead. Now you can do that because I'm going to do a bunch of fluff and a bunch of shout-outs, and I'm going to show love and appreciation for each and every one of my active viewers and commenters. So anyway, let's go ahead and get into some shout-outs, as that was a really tough segment to get into because I have on my sheet here that first game started at 6:35, but it doesn't. The second game starts at 6:35, so I'm a little bit confused there, but I think you guys are smart enough and good enough handicappers to get through it. But anyway, we got some shout outs to get to, brought to you by patreon.com/Brock Page. Now, I just got to remind you guys real quick before we get into the shout outs. We're 5-1 in our last 6 daily best plays on patreon.com. That is the core membership. That's our $1.99 membership. So for just $1.99 per month, you could have gone 5-1 in our last 6 daily best plays. We're also 7-1 in our last 8 NHL plays. So if I'm betting hockey, you might as well think about getting on it, because I am 7-1 in my last 8 hockey plays on that site. Once again, that's patreon.com/brockpage. Link for that site is in the description section below. It's very, very easy to use. If I can operate it, and I'm a big dummy, I'm a goof, if I can operate it, you sure as hell can navigate it. Patreon.com/brockpage. Let's get into some shout outs. Got to give a shout out to Chuck Pinter, RMS, RMS, Ulysses, Willie Mays Hayes, my good friend, the U-Dog, Vidal, 691, Dave Delano at Get Sports Strong, great YouTube channel there. If you're into some more sports betting information, that is Get Sports Strong. Dave Delano, great guy. You know, he approaches it the proper way, right? So if we have channels that are producing similar content, we need to be complimentary towards each other, right? Because the more people are viewing videos in our community, the more videos or the more views we're all gonna get. It's not like traditional business where you're just crushing the other guy. No, like the more our community gets exposure, the more views we're all gonna get. So if you come onto my page and you're like, dude, I love your stuff, you're great, I'm gonna plug you. If you come on and say, this guy stinks, he's bald and his beard smells of cheese, I'm not gonna plug you, because you're not coming about it the right way. We're all in the same cause here, man. We're divulging information to our friends, to our colleagues. So do it right, like Dave from Get Sports Strong, and check out his YouTube channel and subscribe to him. Check him out. That's Get Sports Strong, Dave Delano. Next shout out, Jefferson Steelflex, straight to the point. Will Fresh Prince of Bel Air Smith. We have Mark Stetzel. Jamie Wong. What was my nickname for you, Jamie? I had a good one for you yesterday. Jamie, two Wongs don't make it right? I don't know. I forget. Jamie Wong, what's up? Danny Smoking a Ginormous J. Wow, totally butchered that. Let's try that again. Danny J. Danny Smoking a Ginormous J. We also have Jimmy Big Johnson, Jeremy Fod Kalimpo, Nenad Markovic, Addison Steve and Bindi Irwin, David Bruce Lee, who said, what the F is all up with all those shout outs? Get to the effing point. David Bruce Lee, coming at my neck hard. Come on, young bull. You know that's how we do it. Up in the 215. I mean, oops. I don't know what Wawa is. But anyway, young bull, David Lee. What the F is up with all this shootout? Get to the effing point. All right, Dave. Well, I guess this is the last day of shoutouts. Thanks for ruining it for everyone. No, I got love for you, Dave Lee. That's hilarious, man. I wish that would have showed up in the comment section, but any type of cursing and swearing YouTube flags it. But Dave Lee, much love for you, man. I hear you. What's up with the shoutouts? I don't know, man. We're just having fun. But we're about to get back into the meat and potatoes, the substance. So let's go ahead and get into it and slide back into some more lines and personal leans. We got the Pirates taking on the Diamondbacks. 3:40 Eastern first pitch in Arizona. The Diamondbacks open the betting as the $1.65 favorite. Total at 8 flat. And since those markets open this one up, we're seeing a 10-cent fade of the Diamondbacks and movement downward on the total, down to 155 and 7.5. So once again, Arizona open 165, down to minus 155. Total open 8, down to 7.5. 67% of the consensus is leaning toward the Diamondbacks, 57% shaded toward the over. Right now, the Pirates are plus 140 on the money line. The Diamondbacks are plus 130 on the run line. We have Archer for the Pirates, Greinke for the D-backs. Archer's just 1-2 with a 4.33 ERA. Greinke's 5-1 with a 3.16 ERA. Arizona's also second in hits on average, third in walks on average allowed at home. They're also 23-20 straight up overall for the year. Now, Pittsburgh's really struggled against the Diamondbacks. They've been losers in 9 out of their last 10 head-to-head matchups with Arizona. They also rank 26th in scoring. They're averaging just 3.7 runs per contest in that category there. And total-wise, Pittsburgh's 8-4 to the over in their last dozen. Arizona 5-1 to the over in their last six at home, taking on Pittsburgh. So with all that in mind, I'm going to lean Arizona minus 155 in the over, 7.5 in that game. Next matchup. Toronto, San Francisco, 3:45 Eastern first pitch in San Fran. We have two guys making their first starts on the season. We have Edwin Jackson for the Blue Jays, Sean Anderson for the Giants. Once again, both pitchers, both probables, making their first starts of the year. And believe it or not, this is Edwin Jackson's eighth team in his last five seasons. If you remember, Edwin was with the Athletics last year. And had a no-hitter. So, anyway, give me Toronto on the money line, winning that one outright. Next game, Orioles-Yankees. Game two of the double dip, 6:35 Eastern first pitch. Looks like we have Andrew Cashner for the O's, Domingo Herman for the Yankees. And sorry, I said that very authentically. Sorry, Domingo German for the Yankees. But once again, Andrew Cashner for the O's, Domingo Herman for the Yankees. Cashner's coming into this game with a 4.25 ERA. Once again, that's a probable in the second of a doubleheader, so no guarantees there. And now on the other side, Domingo Herman is 7-1 with a 2.70 ERA for the Yankees. Absolutely dominant. So if these pitchers do swear off, I got to lean Yankees in this one. Give me New York -1.5, getting the job done on the run line, as there's no line for that game. I don't have any odds for you. No line for that game, no total. But once again, I like the Yankees -1.5, getting the job done on the run line. Next matchup, Cubbies, Reds, 6:40 Eastern first pitch in Cincinnati. Now we've had a good old-fashioned flip of the lines in this one. The Reds open +105, total 9.5. We're seeing a 20-cent move towards Cincinnati. They're now -115, total at 9 flat. So once again, Cincinnati open +105 up to -115. Total open 9.5 down to 9 flat. 64% are leaning Cubbies, 51% shaded toward the over. Right now, Chicago's +105 on the money line. Cincinnati +170 on the run line. We have Yu Darvish for the Cubs, Gray for the Reds. Gray comes into this matchup with an 0-4 record and a 3.92 ERA. Now, the Cubbies are first in road scoring, first in road hits. Cincinnati's just 18-24 straight up overall. They rank dead last in hits on average per game. Total-wise, Cincinnati's 80% of the over at home. Give me the Cubbies +105 in the over, 9 runs in that game. Next matchup, Brewers, Phillies, 7:05 Citizens Bank Park. The Phillies open $1.20, total 8.5. We're seeing a 10-cent move toward Philadelphia and movement upward on the total, -130 and 9 flat. So once again, the Fightins, that's right, the Fightin' Phils, the Fightins open $1.20 up to -130, total open 8.5 up to 9 flat. 52% are leaning Phils, 64% shaded toward the under. Right now, Milwaukee's +115 on the money line. Philly +$1.65 on the run line. Pretty good pitching matchup here. We have Gio Gonzalez for the Brewers, Jake Arrieta for the Phils. Gio comes into this game with a 1-0 record and a 1.69 ERA for the Brewers. Milwaukee's also 8-3 in their last 11. They're 25-19 overall for the year, and they rank fourth in offensive walks on the road, so really doing a good job getting runners on base. Now, Philly, on the other side, they're just allowing runners to get on base. They're 26th in hits allowed. They're also 27th in striking batters out at home. I think this is a pretty good spot for a pitcher like Gio Gonzalez, who's been throwing as well as he has so far in the season. So give me Milwaukee +115 in the over. 9 runs in that matchup there. You know, it's really difficult to have a podcast when you have permanent mush mouth and you just go, Milwaukee. But anyway, thank you guys for bearing with me. Next game, Mets, Nationals. 7:05 Eastern first pitch in the nation's capital. Washington opened $1.65, total 8.5. Nickel fade of the Nats and movement downward on the total, 160 and 8 flat. Once again, Washington opened $1.65 down to -160. Total open 8.5 down to 8 flat. 64% are leaning Nationals, 54% shaded toward the over. Right now the Mets are +145 on the money line. Washington +125 on the run line. We have Font for the Mets, Corbin for the Nats. The Mets are 9th in hits on the road, 6th in striking batters out on the road, 4-1 in their last 5, 14-9 against the spread away from home. And of course, in Major League Baseball, when I refer to the spread, I'm actually referring to the run line. So 14-9 in their run line plays away from home, 14-9 against the spread in that category there. Now, Washington has dropped 7 out of their last 9. They're also just 1-4 straight up in their last 5 at home. When it comes to the scoring, Washington is 4-2 to the over in their last 6 taking on the Mets. I like the road dog in this one. Pretty good equity here. Give me the Mets +1.5 and the over. 8 runs in that game. Next matchup, we have Astros, Tigers, 7:10 Eastern first pitch in Detroit. Pretty good matchup here. Actually, not really. Verlander for the Astros, Greg Soto for the Tigers. Now, Verlander 6-1 with a 2.51 ERA. Greg Soto comes into this game with an 0-1 record and a 15.75 ERA. I don't have the whip, but I'm sure that's pretty high as well. No line on this game as of yet. No money line, no total, no line on this game. But I think Houston should get the job done. Give me Houston -1.5 getting the job done on the run line in that game there. Next matchup, Rays, Marlins, 7:10 Eastern first pitch in Miami. Another interesting pitching matchup here. We have Ryan Stanek for the Rays, Jose Ureña for Miami. Now, Ureña has won, I think, just one game in the last 4 seasons. One of the worst pitchers I've ever seen. Let me know in the comments section below, who's worse, Ureña or Homer Bailey? I mean, those two guys are terrible, but I think Homer Bailey has like 3 or 4 wins this year. Ureña just is horrible. How does he still have a job? Anyway, Ryan Stanek for the Rays, 2.57 ERA. Ureña, 1-5 with a 4.63 ERA. Now, Tampa Bay's first in runs allowed. They're 25-15 overall for the year. Miami has played 40 games and has won just 10 of them. Winners in just 10 out of 40 games this year. 10-30 straight up overall for the year. Now, there's no line posted for this game either. No money line, no total. We haven't seen a line posted for this matchup, but I think Tampa Bay should win by at least 2 here in this spot. So give me the Rays, -1.5. Getting the job done on the run line in that matchup there. All right, we're down on the home stretch. Let's take a look at the Rockies taking on the Red Sox, 7:10 Eastern first pitch at Fenway. Boston opened $1.35, total 8.5. 15-cent move toward the Red Sox up to $1.50. Once again, the Sox opened 135 up to -150. Total's 8.5. 65% are leaning Boston, 80% shaded toward the over. Right now, Colorado's +$1.35 on the money line. Boston +135 on the run line. We have Herman Marquez for the Rockies. Eduardo Rodriguez for the Red Sox. Rodriguez is 4-2. Did I say German? German Marquez? Herman Marquez. It's Marquez for the Rockies, Rodriguez for the Sox. Rodriguez is 4-2 so far in the year. Boston is 2nd in home scoring, 1st in home walks. Winners in 5 out of their last 6 straight up. And they are 11-8 at Fenway this year. Now, Colorado on the other side, well, they've been winners in just 5 out of their last 15 meetings taking on Boston. So if you're into historical trends, really, the Rockies not faring all too well against this Red Sox team. Once again, just 5-10 in their last 15 taking on the Sox. Colorado is just 20-21 overall for the year, and they are striking out 9.8 times per contest on average. That puts them at 28th in that category there. Now, total-wise, Colorado is 10-1 to the over in their last 11. They're also 7-2 to the over in their last 9 away from home. So I think we will see some scoring in this one. Give me Boston -150 in the over 8.5 in that game. Next matchup, we have Cardinals Braves, and that is going to be a 7:20 Eastern first pitch at SunTrust Park in Atlanta. The Braves open 140, total at 9. Nickel move toward the Braves and movement upward up to 9.5. So once again, the Braves open 140 up to minus 145. Total open 9 up to 9.5. 55% are leaning Braves, 61% shaded toward the under. Right now the Cardinals are plus 130 on the money line, Braves plus 135 on the run line. We have Michael Wacha for the Cards, Mike Soroka for the Braves. Wacha comes into this game with a 3-0 record, and as good as Mike Soroka's been, the St. Louis team is 12-7 against the spread away from home. Once again, 12-7 in their last 19 run line plays away from home. The Cards also rank fourth in road hits. Now, Atlanta really struggling at home this year. Losers in 8 out of their last 11 at home. They also rank 23rd in walking batters at home as well. Now, total-wise, like I said, Soroka is having a good start of the year. He is 3-1 with a 1-2-1 ERA. So although I think Atlanta won't get the job done, we probably won't see as much scoring as the as most markets project. So with all that in mind, I'm going to lean St. Louis plus 1.5 in the under 9.5 runs in that game. All right, next matchup. Interesting one here. Texas, Kansas City. I like the Rangers minus 125 in the over 9 runs in that game. Next and final game for the show, it is going to be Padres, Dodgers, 10-10, Los Angeles. The Dodgers open 170, total at 8. 20-cent fade of the Dodgers down to 150. Once again, Los Angeles open 170, down to minus 150. Totals at 8. 65% are leaning Dodgers, 69% shaded toward the under. Right now, the Padres are plus 135 on the money line. Dodgers plus 130 on the run line. We have Matt Stram for the Padres, Kenta Maeda for the Dodgers. Stram's just 1-2 on the year. Meanwhile, Maeda 4-2 record on the year thus far. The Dodgers are 5th in home scoring, 3rd in home hits. They are 28-16 overall so far this season, 12 games over 500 in this early season. They're also 18-6 at Dodger Stadium. The Padres on the other side, 2-4 straight up in their last 6. They rank 22nd in hits allowed on the road. And when it comes to the total, San Diego 67% to the over in their last 9, 80% to the over in their last 5 on the road. Dodgers on the other side, 5-1 to the over in their last 6, taking on San Diego. I like the Dodgers minus 150 in the over 8 runs in that matchup there. All right, guys, that's going to do it for me. It's been fun talking about Sheetz with you guys. Or no, I'm sorry, it's Wawa. I thought it was Sheetz. Definitely not Rutters, though. Anyway, great to see you guys. Thank you for tuning in. That is going to do it for me. Don't forget to check me out on patreon.com/brockpage. I said it a couple times earlier. We're doing very well. What are we? 7-1 in our last 8 NHL plays on that site. Absolutely crushing it. We're 5-1 in our last 6 daily best plays. So check me out. Link is in the description section below, patreon.com/brockpage. But most importantly, thank you for watching this free programming right here on YouTube. I really hope you enjoyed all this great free information. I'm on my way to get my marriage license. So yeah, we're going to get that done in about an hour. I know my man G&G, the cigar smoker, he said, "You really are a gambler." Yeah, gambling my life away, but I don't look at it that way. I look at it as this. I can give 100% of my money to the casino as a single man, or 50% to a nice person and our little family. So anyway, that is going to do it for me. Thanks for tuning in once again. And don't forget to check me out on patreon.com/brockpage.